Hi, I'm Marlen Esparza, Olympic boxer for Team USA. I won a bronze medal at the 2012 London Olympic Games. And fun fact, I was the first woman to ever qualify for the Olympic Games in boxing. Now I'm gonna show you some tips. Okay, so now we're gonna get into some tech sparring. Tech sparring is important because it's like sparring, but it helps slow things down to make sure that you're in the right position all the time. Where your foot is, where your head is, where your hands are, it's about repetition. Tech sparring is something that I use about 2-3 times a week to make sure that I have everything sealed down and compact in my head. So whenever I am doing my live sparring, I can really just think about going full force versus really working on the technicalities. The first drill that I'm gonna use is, again, one of the most important, using your jabs, using your front hands. And it's also teaching you to avoid somebody in front of you. And that's what's important about tech sparring, is that you actually get to see a person, see their movement, and then you're able to transition that into live work. So we're gonna start as A side's gonna throw by using her front hand, her jab, and I'm B side, so all I'm gonna do is make sure that I avoid that punch. Not knowing when it's coming. You don't just have to use head movement. This is real boxing situation. You can move your feet, you can move your head, you can pick up your hands, anything you want to do to avoid the punch. B side will go next. Again, she's only gonna have to watch this hand and she can avoid it any way she wants. You don't wanna go too slow because then it's not realistic. You don't wanna hit too hard because it's not live sparring. And you don't wanna go too fast because you also want to make sure that you and the person that you're working with are able to register what's happening. The next punch that we're gonna be doing is the straight right. For southpaw would be the straight left. So it's the next punch that a lot of people use right after the jab. It's one of your strongest punches because you use your dominant hand on your backside. So you can use your weaker hand to set things up and your stronger hand to land. And then now, B side. A lot of mistakes that people tend to make on this is that they won't bring their hands back to their face and they will try to anticipate the punch too much. You need to go with the flow. So if I throw my straight right and she doesn't know what's coming, she needs to just make her reaction the way it is. She doesn't have to do anything specific just as long as she's avoiding the punch. Some people get too stuck on what they have to do and they don't let it flow. Also, elbows. I've been boxing for 20 years, still have the same problem. When you're tech sparring and you're throwing and avoiding, make sure that you keep your elbows in. This is just for repetition and making sure that when you are in live sparring or fighting, that you always have the unconscious ability to protect your body. Now that you know a little bit about tech sparring, I just want you guys to remember the main things. Tech sparring is not about live contact. It's about using specific situations so you can better understand your timing and your distance, making sure that you don't hit your partner too hard, making sure that you don't go too slow because it needs to be realistic, and that you're making sure that it's not too fast because you have to make sure that everybody is understanding what's happening. I really hope that you use these and be safe. Thanks for watching. Check out more tips on the Olympic Channel. That was good. Okay, now we're gonna go back to. It's good. She hit me. It's good.